Hey, good evening, Sammy. Let's see who's going to be in the class today. I only have two students so far, so let's wait a little bit, okay?
Hello, teacher, I am late.
Don't worry, it's okay.
Always, I am a bit late.
Don't worry, it's okay. Okay. You know, I understand that you guys have a lot of, you know.
Okay, thank you.
Before coming to class, don't worry. Let's see. For today, we're going to talk about time expressions. And let's see here. Okay, here it is, time expressions. Let's see how many students. Oh, Jesse and Sammy, you guys are the only ones. So let's wait a little bit. So how was your day today?
It was beautiful.
It was beautiful, okay.
It was beautiful because I was in my house all day, as always.
That's good. Good to know. Sammy,
I am very secure.
Very secure. Good. Yes, Sammy, how was your day?
¿Cómo estaba mi día, si no me equivoco?
Yes, how was your day?
¿Cómo se dice cansado?
Tired, very tired.
Very tired.
Oh man, I'm so sorry. You were working? ¿Estuvo trabajando?
Yes, and business all.
The whole day, todo el día.
No, en la tarde, ¿cómo se dice? Por la tarde.
In the afternoon.
Mm-hmm, in the afternoon.
Okay, good. I see Rocío is coming. Rocío, how are you?
Fine, thank you, teacher.
Nice to see you today. Nice to see you. I'm glad. You can say I'm glad to see you. Don't worry. Okay, today is Thursday, right? Today is the last class of the week. Thursday. What is June 11th, 2018. Very good. There it is. Let me see what is for today. Man, my internet is very slow right now. Somebody's using my internet. Start working fine. Oh, time expressions. There it is. So you guys have been doing your homework? Are you having like any problems or everything is good?
Teacher?
Yes.
In my case, I was study a little bit, but in my case I need to practice so I can get more easily, but now yes, I have a problem. But I hope that I understand very well.
Okay, you are in the group. I don't know who created the group in WhatsApp. You are in the group,
yeah.
WhatsApp group. Okay, starting from tomorrow, I'm going to be sending some videos so you can practice. Okay.
Okay.
That is beginners.
Okay.
Only for beginners. So I'm going to start sending you guys so you can guys you can practice. And if you have any questions, ask me. Okay, at any time.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, thank you.
Okay, so we're going to begin with the video in the platform. You know, for English. What is it? Inglés corporativo. They have one video for you, so let's go see it. Let me share it with you right now. Here we go. Compartir sonido and optimizar video. There you go. Can everybody see this?
Yes.
Good. Okay. So we're going to talk about time expressions. Okay, let's see this.
By the end of this lesson, participants will be able to identify and use time expressions such as prepositions and adverbs of time.
Time expressions.
I get up at 7 in the morning on weekdays.
I go to bed around 10 in the evening on weeknights.
I leave work early in the afternoon on weekends.
I get home late at night on Fridays.
I stay up until midnight on Saturdays.
I wake up before noon on Sundays. I wake up afternoon on Sundays.
Expressing clock time.
7. 7. 7 o'clock. 7 a.m. equals 7 in the morning. 7 p.m. equals 7 in the evening.
Okay, so now let's talk about at, in, and on. At. This preposition of time is used to discuss a specific time, including exceptions such as night. Examples, we have classes at 8 p.m. We have classes at 8 at night. In. This preposition of time is used to discuss general times of day except night, months, and years. Examples, we have classes in the morning. My graduation is in June. I went to Mexico in 1989. On. This preposition of time is used to discuss certain days of the week or portions of days of the week, specific dates. Examples, we will meet on Friday. I rest on weekends. Christmas is on December 25th.
Okay, let's see. I want to go here.
Equals 7 in the evening.
Oh, no. I want this one. Here we go. Okay, what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to take a screenshot and we're going to discuss this little paragraph or this little thing here. Let me see, screenshot. Bam. Go ahead and take it from here. There it is. Now, I'm going to use PowerPoint. I'm going to use PowerPoint for this. Let's see. I know you guys cannot see this right now because I'm preparing the PowerPoint with the screenshot. Give me a couple minutes so I can do it. Just a minute. Let's see. Oh, come on. Here we go. And this is to make questions. Yeah, we're going to take care of this. Here we go. Okay, first I need to explain something to you guys. Okay, now I'm going to share it with you guys. What is it? Oh, here. Okay, can everybody see this? Guys, can you see this? Can you see this screen?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Yes, teacher.
Okay, let me do it a little bigger. That's what I like about PowerPoint. A lot of big testing. Mm-hmm. Okay, good. This one. Okay, here we go. Can everybody see it, right?
Yes.
Okay. There we go. Okay, as you can see, we have time expression. For example, I get up at 7 p.m. I go to bed around 10. I go home late. I stay up until midnight. I wake up before noon, or I wake up after noon. Okay, so these are the time expressions, but actually some of them are prepositions of time. So let's see one of them. I get up at 7 a.m. What would be the question for this? Remember that we already know four tenses. What are the four tenses that we know? Guys, what are the four tenses that you already know?
At?
No.
Present.
Okay, present is one. Yes. Another one?
Future?
Yeah. The question is, how many tenses do you know right now? Remember, we were practicing all the tenses. How many tenses do we know?
Six sentences.
Wait.
For example, what time do you get up?
No, guys. You guys are forgetting. Okay, remember that a couple of days ago, we were practicing four tenses. So what are the tenses that you already know? The ones that we were practicing. What is tense number one? What is tense number one? Ay, come on, we were talking the whole, since last week.
Present continuous, and simple future. Simple past and simple present.
So those are the tenses that we already know. Come on, guys, don't forget. Present continuous, simple future, simple past, and simple present. Okay, so we already know that. Now, what I'm trying to do here with this is that we're going to talk about this this little presentation, okay, after the video. So let's do it one more time. Let's see, one more time. No, here, this one. Okay, so the preposition of time is, I get up at 7 p.m. So this is the answer. What would be the question in present continuous?
What time is it?
No.
What time is it do you
No.
get up?
What time is it es que hora es?
What time is it do you get up?
No. Anybody else?
Present continuous.
Yes. Actually, look. This answer is in simple present. It's in simple present, okay? So, the question in simple present will be,
What time do you get up?
Very good. So, what time do you get up? Entonces, obtenemos esta respuesta. I get up at 7 p.m. at 7. I get up at 7. So, la respuesta en presente continuo. Hacemos en pasado simple. ¿Cómo sería la pregunta?
What time did you get up?
Very good. What time did you get up? Everybody repeat.
What time did you get up?
What time did you get up? Otra vez.
What time did you get up? I said, what time is it do you get up? what time do you get up in simple present?
No, simple present, yes. But entonces, en pasado simple estamos diciendo,
what time did you get up?
¿A qué horas te levantaste? ¿Cómo sería la respuesta en pasado? Tenemos que saber cuál es el verbo en pasado. ¿Cuál es get en pasado?
Woke up.
Bueno, el verbo get, ¿cómo es en pasado?
Got.
La respuesta es
I got up.
I got up.
I got up at seven.
Yo me levanté a las 7. I got up at 7. Everybody? Repeat.
I get up.
No, I got up.
I got up at seven.
I got up at 7.
Okay, so that's important. ¿Cómo sería en futuro simple? La pregunta primero.
¿Cómo?
¿Cómo sería en futuro
simple? What time are you going to get up?
What time are you going to get up? Repeat.
What time are you going to get up?
¿Cómo sería la respuesta?
I am going to get up at 7.
Very good. I'm going to get up at 7. ¿Todos?
I'm going to get up at 7.
So, ahora en presente continuo. ¿Cuál sería la pregunta?
What time are you going?
Presente continuo.
What time are you getting up?
Exactly. What time are you getting up? Todo.
What time are you getting up?
Otra vez.
What time are you getting up?
¿Cuál sería la respuesta?
I'm going to get up.
¿Por qué dice going? ¿Qué es futuro? Come on.
I'm getting up.
I'm getting up at seven.
Yes, I'm getting up at 7. ¿Todos?
I'm getting up at seven.
I'm getting up at seven.
En los cuatro tiempos. Let's go to the next. I go to bed around 10. ¿Esta está en qué tiempo está? I go to bed around 10.
En past.
In the future.
No, I go to bed.
De hecho, todas están
present. En
future.
Presente simple. Todas
están present. En
So, ¿cómo sería la pregunta? ¿Cómo sería la pregunta?
What time do you go to bed?
Yes, very good. What time do you go to bed?
What time do you go to bed?
Todos.
What time do you go to bed?
Está diciendo what time. No es what time, es what time. What time?
What time?
What time?
What time?
What time?
What time?
What time
do you go
what
to
time?
Bed?
Do
go to bed.
I to bed.
Y la respuesta es I go to bed around 10.
I go to bed around 10.
¿Qué significa eso? I go to bed around 10. ¿Qué significa?
Me voy alrededor de las 10.
Bien. ¿Cómo sería en presente continuo la pregunta?
What time are you going?
What time are you going to bed?
No.
What time are you getting up?
No. Estamos en la segunda. Go to bed.
What time are you going to bed?
Go to bed. No.
What time?
Yes. Ese es
gonna.
Simple. Ese es futuro.
No, ya lo habían dicho, no sé quién lo dijo, pero es What time are you going to bed? So, ¿cuál sería la respuesta?
I'm going to bed.
Around 10.
Yes, I'm going to bed around 10. Everybody?
I go to bed around 10.
Alguien dice, I go to bed. No,
I'm going to bed.
I'm going to bed.
Around 10.
Miren, se están equivocando mucho porque no escuchan. O sea, déjenme terminar y después de mí repiten. Por eso es que no lo dicen bien. ¿Ok? Ok, vamos. Si digo, I'm going to bed around 10. Ahí estoy diciendo, yo me voy, me estoy yendo a la cama alrededor de las 10. ¿Ok? I'm going to bed around 10. ¿Todos?
I'm going to bed
around 10.
Ahora hagamos el futuro simple. ¿Cómo sería la pregunta en futuro simple?
What time are you going to bed?
What time are you going?
No.
No, going.
Going to bed.
What time are you going to bed?
No. Ese es el presente continuo, lo acabamos de hacer.
Ah, I get it. Wait, no. Ah, no. What time are you getting? Going to bed.
No.
I did.
No. What time are you going to go to bed? What time are you going to go to bed? ¿A qué horas te vas a ir a la cama? Todos. What time are you going to go to bed?
What time are you going to go to bed?
No. Listen. What time are you going to go to bed?
What time I'll go?
What time are you going to go to bed?
What time are you going to go to bed?
No. Listen.
Teacher.
Can you repeat that, please, slowly?
Teacher,
yeah.
I think that's...
You don't understand.
Como no me dejan terminar, sino que en medio de lo que yo estoy diciendo, empiezan ustedes a hablar. Entonces, déjenme terminar para que ustedes agarren toda la oración y de allí comienzan ustedes.
Okay. Ah, pero yo me he confundido con los tiempos.
Lo hemos practicado desde la semana pasada.
Como que estoy bloqueada.
No importa. Bueno. Con tal que lo practiquemos y se vaya dando cuenta cómo utilizarlo, así se va dando. No hay problema. ¿Eh?
Ok.
Va, ¿en cuál es? Go to bed, right?
So, in the future.
I'm going to go to bed around 10. ¿Todos?
I go to bed.
I'm going
around 10.
I'm going to bed.
No, listen. I'm going to go to bed around.
I'm going to go to bed.
Around 10.
Around 10.
I'm going to go to bed around 10.
I go to bed around 10.
I go to bed around 10. Go to bed.
I go to bed around
10. No, no es así. Usted está diciendo, I go to bed around 10. Ese es presente simple. Estamos haciendo futuro simple. I'm going to go to bed around 10.
I'm going to bed around 10.
I'm going to go to bed around 10.
¿Por qué am? No entiendo, porque no está la M. Am.
I am going, es la clave.
I'm going to go to bed around 10.
Es que yo creo que nos estamos confundiendo en el presente continuo y el futuro por la palabra, por el verbo de going.
Por eso, going y no going to es de...
pero es que nos estamos confundiendo porque como se dice en el continuo going... Y en el futuro simple también, are you going?
No, to? Por eso.
Ahí no estamos enchibolando con eso.
No sé qué dice el teacher ahí, pero yo
lo que sucede, entiendo, compañero, es que cuando nosotros usamos en español voy a ir. Entonces, cuando nosotros decimos going y go, es como que se refería en el español. Voy a ir, por eso es going to go. Voy a ir. Eso es lo que nos quiere darle.
Okay, listen to this. I have put every microphone off. I put your microphone off because I need to explain to you. Les puse silenciado el micrófono porque necesito que entiendan algo, okay? Listen to this. We were talking about the four tenses that you already studied. Son cuatro tiempos de que ustedes ya estudiaron, de que ya los deben de saber, okay? So, present continuous. Ojo, la clave está en que entiendan cómo se utiliza el presente continuo. Si yo digo present continuous, how do we know that we're using it? ¿Cómo sabemos cómo lo estamos utilizando? Porque los verbos llevan ing al final. Cada verbo, si digo drink, beber, pero si lo quiero pasar al presente continuo, va a ser drinking. Le voy a poner ing, presente continuo. Número dos, futuro simple. How do we know that we're using the simple future? Because we use going to. So, sabemos de que utilizamos futuro simple cuando vemos de que utilizamos going to. I'm going to drink. Antes del verbo tiene que ser going to. Ese es presente simple. Pasado simple. How do we know that we're using simple past? ¿Cómo sabemos que utilizamos pasado simple? Porque en las preguntas utilizamos el auxiliar did. D-I-D. Did. Y en las respuestas vamos a cambiar el verbo al pasado. Ese es un poco complicado porque los verbos en pasado pueden ser regulares o puede ser irregular. ¿Ya? Y número cuatro, el presente simple. ¿Cómo sabemos que lo utilizamos? How do we know that we're using simple present? Because we use the auxiliaries do and does. Porque utilizamos los auxiliares do y does. Do para primeras personas y plurales y does para terceras personas singulares. Y ahí está. Ese es todo el misterio de los cuatro tiempos. Lo que pasa es que ustedes no me lo están estudiando. Por eso es que en cada clase se olvidan de los tiempos. ¿Ok? Ahora sí. ¿Alguna pregunta que tenga?
Yeah, ok. Got it.
¿Questions? No questions.
No, teacher, no. The reason was because I was very confused with the future simple. I understand that you told us going to, and the picture has I go, in the screen, I think I go, but it's missing to. This is the reason why I'm very confused.
No,
check the screen.
No, the thing is that you need to convert them. No siempre va a haber un texto definido. Usted tiene que convertirlo.
Ajá, por eso yo me confundí. Es por eso que no veía el tú.
Lo dejo de así porque nosotros tenemos que convertirlo.
Ajá.
Tenemos que pasar. Usted tiene que aprender a pasarlo de presente a futuro. De presente a pasado. De presente a presente continuo. O sea,
sí, no veía el tú, por eso me confundía. Pero ya. Ya
lo
entendí.
Ok, any other question? ¿Alguna otra pregunta que tengan antes de continuar con el ejercicio? Come on, guys. No, ok, moving on. Vamos al ejercicio entonces. Let's go here. And here we are, one more time. Okay, so I get up, I go to bed, that's done. Let's go with I leave work early. What does this mean? What does it mean when I said I leave work? What does it mean, leave work?
Future. Future, leave work.
No, no, no.
I don't know. Okay. Present. I don't know later.
Remember, I told you that all of these are in simple present. All of these are in simple present.
Yeah.
What I'm asking is, what does it mean in Spanish? I leave work early.
Voy al trabajo temprano.
No.
Dejar el trabajo.
Me voy del trabajo. Me voy del trabajo temprano. Okay. I leave work early. Me voy del trabajo o dejo el trabajo temprano. Significa que es la salida. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it is in simple present. So what is the question here? How do we make the question?
What time do you leave work?
Yes, that's good. Simple present. What time do you leave work? Everybody, please.
What time do you leave work?
Okay. What time do you leave work? Very good. So that is the question. So the answer, yes. I leave work early. Notice, noten de que aquí la pregunta dice, ¿a qué horas te vas del trabajo? Pero en la respuesta dice early. En la respuesta dice early. Yo me voy del trabajo temprano. No dice me voy a las 5, me voy a las 4. Pero es válido. Ok. Now let's do for simple past.
What time did you go in? Did work?
What time did you leave work?
Yes. What time did you leave work? What time did you leave work?
Right.
What time did you leave work? Everybody?
What time did you leave work?
¿A qué horas te fuiste del trabajo? What time did you leave work? Everybody?
What time did you leave work?
What time did you leave work?
Okay. Ahora en pasado, ¿cuál sería el pasado, el verbo en pasado de leave?
I left.
Left, very good. L-E-F-T. So, ¿cuál sería la respuesta?
I left work early.
Very good. I left work early. ¿Todos?
I left work early.
Yes, I left work early. ¿Qué sería? Me fui del trabajo temprano. Ok. Very good. Ahora, futuro simple. ¿Cómo sería? La pregunta.
What time are you going to leave work?
What time are you going to leave work? No olviden el to.
Uh-huh.
What time are you going to
leave work?
What time
are you going to leave work?
What time are you going to leave work? Everybody.
What time?
What time are you going to leave work?
Okay. ¿A qué horas te vas a ir del trabajo? Eso sería. So, ¿cuál sería la respuesta?
I'm going to leave work. I leave work early.
I'm going to leave work early. Sí. ¿Todos?
I'm going to leave work early.
I'm going to leave work early. ¿Todos?
I'm going to leave work early.
Good. Ahora, presente continuo. Present continuous. What is the question?
What time are you leaving work?
Very good.
Leaving work early.
No. What time are you leaving work? Everybody?
What time are you leaving work early?
Are you leaving work early?
No.
No, early is for
en la respuesta.
Para la respuesta. Uh-huh.
Así es.
So, la pregunta sería, what time are you leaving work? Hasta ahí. Todos.
What time are you leaving work?
Okay, y la respuesta sería?
Mm-hmm. I am going to leave work early.
Listen, alguien está diciendo going to. Recuerden que les dije que going to solo para futuro simple. Futuro simple, ok. En
presente continuo.
I'm leaving work early.
Yes, I'm leaving work early. Todos.
I'm leaving work early.
Bye. ¿Qué sería? Me estoy yendo del trabajo temprano. Bien. Next. Let's go with I get home late. I get home late. ¿Qué significa I get home late?
Arribar. Llegué tarde. I get estar tarde.
Llego.
Llegar.
Yo
llegar.
Llego a casa tarde. Yo llego a casa tarde. ¿Eh? So, está en presente simple. So, ¿cuál es la pregunta?
What time do you get home?
What time do you get home? Very good. What time do you get home? So, la respuesta, I get home late. Yo llego a casa tarde. Okay? So, presente continuo, ¿cómo sería? Pregunta.
Are you getting home late?
No, siempre con what time.
What time are you getting home?
Yes, what time are you getting home? Hasta ahí. Todos, what time are you getting home?
What time are you getting home?
Good. Y la respuesta, I'm getting home late.
I'm getting home late.
Yes. Okay.
I'm getting home late.
Futuro simple, ¿cómo sería la pregunta?
What time going to get home?
No. Falta el sujeto.
What time are you?
Yes. What time are you going to get home?
To get home.
What time are you going to get home? Todos.
What time are you going to get home?
Okay, otra vez. What time are you going to get home?
What time are you going to get home?
Very good. ¿Y la respuesta?
I am going to get home late.
Yes, very good. I'm going to get home late. Todos.
I'm going to get home late.
I'm going to get home late.
Going to.
I'm going.
I need to get home late.
Okay. So, the simple future, simple past. The question. Simple past question.
What time did you get home?
Everybody.
What time did you get home?
No head. Get. What time did you get home? Good. ¿A qué horas llegaste a casa? ¿Y cuál sería la respuesta? ¿Cómo dijimos que era el verbo get en pasado?
Got.
Ajá, eso
sí. I got home late.
Okay, good. So let's move on to the next one, which is I stay up. ¿Qué significa I stay up?
Stay up.
Tú estás.
Esa sería como quedarse despierto. En este caso, I stayed up until midnight. Yo me quedo despierto hasta la medianoche. Ok, so, ¿cuál sería la pregunta?
What time do you stay up? Simple present.
Sí, simple present, yes.
Uh-huh.
What time do you stay up? What time do you stay up? What time do you? stay up?
Okay, good. What time do you stay up? Everybody.
What time do you stay up?
Good. Y la respuesta es, I stayed up until midnight.
Everybody? I stayed up until midnight.
Good. Present continuous.
What time are you staying up?
Yes. What time are you staying up? Todos.
What time are you staying up?
Okay. Y la respuesta es.
I'm staying up.
Until midnight. I'm staying up until midnight. Todos.
I'm staying up until midnight.
Okay. Ahora futuro simple.
What time are you going to stay up?
Yes. What time are you going to stay up? Todos.
What time are you going to stay up?
What time are you going to stay up? Everybody.
What time are you going to stay up?
Yes. And what is the answer?
I'm going to stay up until midnight.
Good. Okay, pero pasado simple. Let's do simple past. Question. ¿Cuál es el auxiliar del pasado? What time did you stay up? Okay. Este verbo en pasado solo se le agrega ed y se pronuncia
I stayed up until midnight.
Very good. Okay, let's go for the last. Vamos a la última. I wake up before noon. O también, I wake up after noon. So, ¿qué significa wake up?
¿A qué hora te levantas?
Despertarse.
Ojo, get up es levantarse y wake up, despertarse. Cuando uno abre los ojos. Okay. I wake up before noon. So, ¿cuál sería la pregunta aquí?
What do you wake up?
No.
What time do you wake up?
Yes. What time do you wake up?
What time do you wake up?
Okay. ¿Y cuál sería la respuesta? ¿Cómo cambia el verbo wake en pasado?
Walk.
Very good. W-O-K-E. Walk. So la respuesta sería?
I woke up before noon.
Yes, I woke up before noon. Everybody. I woke up before noon.
I woke up before noon.
Very good. Okay, that's nice. Okay, we finish with that. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Okay, guys. Definitely, we are missing, or you guys are forgetting the four tenses. So what I'm going to do is that tomorrow. Okay, so tomorrow what I'm going to do is that I'm going to continue explaining the four tenses. It doesn't matter if I have to explain three times, four times, or five times. The main thing is for you to remember other days. Don't worry, I can explain it every day if you want to, okay? But the thing is that we need to practice it too, okay? So tomorrow, I'm going to prepare the practice for the four tenses. Oh, well, Monday, sorry. Today is Thursday. Today is the last day of the week. So on Monday. On Monday, we're going
the other week.
Yes, next week. Next week, we're going to.
Next week, continue. I'm sorry, next week.
Okay, so I'm going to prepare the practice for the four tenses. So, and then we're going to do it every day so you won't forget, okay? And we're going to see how do we use it in the practice, questions and answers, okay?
Yeah, okay. I need more practice. Okay.
Yes, don't worry, that's the main thing. That's what we need, more practice, you know? Because you need to make questions and you need to hear answers. For example, I need to ask you and you have to give me answer. You need to ask me and I give you answers. So that's how it works. Yeah. Don't worry. If you don't understand right now, we're going to do it the whole week next week, okay? Okay, right now we're going to practice a little bit, okay? Wait, let me put the other presentation because we need to practice today too. Okay, let me open it here. This one. Yes. This one. Yes, this is it. Let me see. Yes. Okay, I'm going to go straight to the practice because we have little time. But next week, we're going to go to the practice, but before to the explanations.
Okay.
Right now, only the practice.
Next week.
next week, explanation and practice.
We are going to cry.
No, don't worry. Hey, remember how we do it. If you think it's going to be hard, then you're going to feel pressure.
Yes. It's
going to be easy.
We need only practice.
Okay. So let's share it. Simple present, there you go. Okay, here we go. Remember this, right?
Yes.
Can everybody see?
Yeah.
Very good. Okay, so let's take, give me one verse so we can practice. Give me one bird.
Sleep.
Okay, very good. It's good because it's already 9 o'clock. Okay, so let's see. Sleep. So, what is the bird sleep in present continuous? What is sleep in present continuous? The bird.
Sleeping.
Sleeping. In simple future, going to sleep.
Uh-huh.
In simple past, slept.
Uh-huh.
In simple present, sleep.
Uh-huh.
So we have sleeping, going to sleep, slept, and sleep.
Mm-hmm.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Good. So let's practice. First, we're going to practice in one at a time. One WH question at a time in the four tenses, okay? Mm-hmm. Okay, so the present continuous, what is the general question?
What do you do?
No. Present continuous.
Action question. In this moment.
Uh-huh, but what is the general question?
Uh-huh.
What are you?
Mm-hmm. What time?
No. What? No, what time?
What are you sleeping?
No, general question.
What?
What are you doing? Recuerden que la pregunta general necesita saber cuál es el verbo. Por eso dice, what are you doing? ¿Qué estás
haciendo? Ajá, sí. Okay.
So, what are you doing? What are you doing? ¿Todos?
What are you doing?
Okay. ¿Y cuál sería la respuesta?
I am doing nothing.
No. I am sleeping.
I'm sleeping.
Ah, yeah. I am sleeping.
Good. What is the general question for the simple future?
What do you sleep?
Simple future.
Simple future.
General question for simple future.
I'm going to.
What are you going to sleep?
No.
What are you going to sleep?
No. What are you going to?
What are you going to sleep?
No.
Futuro simple.
Uh-huh. Future, simple future. Is what are you going to do?
What are you going to sleep?
What are you?
Yes. What time? Mm-hmm. Sí. Es que no estamos pulsando. So. What are you going to do?
No, es what are you going? What are you going to sleep?
Okay, listen. Cuando decimos en what, cuando trabajamos en what, este generalmente solo es la pregunta general, the general question. Todos los tiempos tienen una pregunta general. So, esa es la que es what. Entonces, por ejemplo, present continuous is what are you going to do? ¿Qué significa qué vas a hacer? Porque queremos saber la acción. Por eso es la pregunta general. Y todos los tiempos empiezan así, con pregunta general. Entonces, la pregunta general de presente continuo, what are you going to do? ¿Qué vas a hacer? La pregunta general de futuro simple, what are you going to do? ¿Qué vas a hacer? La pregunta general de pasado simple, what did you do? ¿Qué hiciste? Y la pregunta general del presente simple, what do you do? ¿Qué haces? Ahora sí, ¿entendimos? So, siempre la pregunta general va a ser la primera porque queremos saber el verbo o la acción. Entonces, por eso es que va a comenzar así. What are you doing? What are you going to do? What did you do? What do you do? Y todos los tiempos tienen una pregunta general para saber la acción. ¿Ok? ¿Questions?
Ok.
No, pues, good. Ok.
No understand.
Okay, so general question in present continuous, what are you doing? And the answer? ¿Cuál sería la respuesta ahí?
What is the question? Tell me, please.
What are you doing?
I am doing, I am sleeping.
Okay, very good. Si digo, what are you going to do? What is the answer?
I am going to sleep.
Very good. I am going to sleep. Si pregunto, what did you do? ¿Cuál sería la respuesta?
I slept.
I slept. Yo dormí. Very good, very good. Y si digo, what do you do?
I am sleeping.
No, what do you do? What do you do?
I sleep.
Okay? Y ahí está la pregunta general. So let's go for question number two. Time. What time? So, pregunta para presente continuo. What time?
Yeah.
Present continuo.
What time are you? Mm-hmm. Are you sleeping?
Yes. What time are you sleeping? Everybody?
What time
are you sleeping?
What times are you sleeping?
And what is the answer?
I am sleeping. Mm-hmm.
I'm sleeping at 7 p.m. Mm-hmm. I'm sleeping at 9 p.m. Okay? Okay, for simple... simple future question.
I am going to sleep. What time are you going to sleep?
Ahora sí. What time are you going to sleep? No olviden el sujeto. Are you? What time are you going to sleep? Okay. So the answer.
What?
I am going to sleep at 7 a.m.
Yes, I'm going to sleep at 10 p.m. Very good. Everybody? I'm going to sleep at 10 p.m.
I'm going to sleep at 10 p.m.
Okay, and what is the answer? I mean, what is the question in simple past?
What times was
no.
are you going?
¿Cuál es
no, no, simple past.
What time, did you?
¿Cuál es el auxiliar del pasado? Come on, guys.
Did.
Okay,
very what good. What time are you did?
What? No.
No, no. What time did uh-huh. you?
Did you
uh-huh.
sleep?
Mm-hmm. What time did you sleep? Everybody.
What time did you sleep?
Okay. ¿Cuál sería la respuesta, Ru?
I slept
mm-hmm.
at 7 p.m.
Very good. I slept at 7 p.m. Todos.
I slept at 10 p.m.
7 p.m.
I slept at 7 p.m.
7 p.m.
Presente simple. Simple present.
What time do you
uh-huh.
sleep?
No, es el pasado.
Sleep.
Uh-huh. Otra vez.
What time do you sleep?
Yes. What time do you sleep? Everybody.
What time do you sleep?
Okay, what is the answer?
I sleep.
What? No.
I sleep at 7 a.m.
Good. I sleep at 8 a.m. Okay, good. Everybody, I sleep at 7 a.m.
I sleep at 7 a.m.
Okay, let's see. Let's leave this out. Okay, guys, listen. So, la meta para el próximo para la próxima semana es que se van a aprender bien al 100% los cuatro tiempos, cómo utilizarlos, cómo reconocerlos, cómo preguntar y cómo contestar los cuatro tiempos. Esa va a ser la meta de la próxima semana. Okay.
So, hey, teacher.
Vamos a ponerle ganas y vamos a hacer así. Pregunta,
yes.
respuesta, pregunta, respuesta. Así nos vamos a hacer, yes. ¿Ok? Ok, so you guys have a good night and I'll see you next week. Have a nice weekend, guys. Have a nice weekend.
Finish?
Oh, okay.
Okay, have a nice weekend. Thank you.
Have a good night.
Good night. Bye.
Bye-bye.